Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I am doing a February bullet journal spread month video. Like filmed me doing it and I decided that you guys might be interested and you know might need some inspiration for your spreads. If you don't know what like bullet journaling is, it's like the basic thing everyone does, but it's actually a lot of fun because it's a way to stay organized on everything that you need. I hope you guys enjoy this video, but yeah, so I'm just gonna get into this video and I really hope you guys enjoy this. Okay, so this is my journal for this new year. So this is what it looks like. This is my February title page. It looks like this. So this spread is obviously Valentine's related because Valentine's is in February and we all love Valentine's Day. This page, and now we're probably gonna go into the voiceover to explain what I did. Okay, to start off with this first page, I just wrote February in a pencil first and just sketched out everything I wanted. And I did it in like the fancy lettering from like those pencils, but I just hand did it. Then I like erased everything, and this is like I do for everyone, but I then trace it in the black pen and I just, you know, like make it bold and stuff. I make some lines bolder than others and stuff, and it makes it look pretty. And then I obviously redid the circle and stuff. And then right over here, I just started doing the vines. So I would like draw them, and then I also did some like black and white ones, and then there's some like colored ones. And I got this idea from Google, so thank you Google so much. But that's what I did. And like throughout the time, I like pick out, and then I like in the video, I start to like color them in and stuff. But I then just picked out the colors I wanted to use for this spread. So like for each spread, I pick out a couple colors just to like pinpoint it on so I don't go crazy with it. That's what those like five little circles are. They're just showing the colors that I'm going to use for the main. That's what like art journals do. But then I colored them in. And then voila. That's what it looks like. And then I just put like two little hearts in there and I think it looks so good. So that was a spread. Yeah, it looks super cute. The end. Next page! Okay, these are the next pages. So I'm gonna, that was like the weirdest voice I've done in a while. Okay, so the next page that I did was I did the moods heart. Like, basically it like, for like, I'm like that little kid that's like, so you like, it's like a mood tracker, except mood hearts because it has hearts in it. And then for the sides, I put the moods down, and it's stress, happy, sad, neutral, which is like just like a regular day. Tired and then irritated. That page, now on to how I did it. Okay, so for this page, it's the mood hearts, but I drew a jar, and that was actually like harder than I thought because you had to make it like symmetrical and stuff. But I wrote down the moods and put down the hearts. I know it's like cut off. I'm a little annoyed about that. But it took me a little while to get that. But I did that and then I like erased everything and then wrote over it with like the black. And then I wrote like mood hearts. And then I started to like color in the moods and stuff and like the colors I wanted. And I put down the dates. And then also by the hearts, you can't really see it, but I put some, vines down of the hearts. So, yeah. I also, like, put pink around it, so woohoo, that too.
Okay.
And this is what it turned out with. I think it looks amazing. Okay. Yep. Next one.
On to the next page. So the next page is my reading one. So as you can see, there's already, like, books on it, but these are the books I'm reading right now, which I figured it's the 29th today and I only have like two more days left in this month, so like I'm obviously not gonna finish those books, so I just put the books on that I'm reading, and it's like the ratings and then my review on the books, like out, like book Goodreads, sorry. So that's what it looks like. I'm actually really happy on how it looks. Yeah, so that's my reading page, and on to how I did it.
Okay, so for my reading page, I wrote the title in pencil and then traced that in the pen and made it all fancy, kind of. And then once I was done with that, I started putting down some of the hearts. I just drew those in like random places, but I think it looks cute. And then I just cut out the covers that I got from Google and then just glued them down slowly. And then I wrote stars over top of it where I wanted them so that I could rate them. And then right next to that, that would be where the review would go by like the little hearts that I put down. So that's basically that, but yeah, I really like it and I can't wait to start reading. Hopefully I read more than this, but okay.
I hope this DIY explaining how I did the pages is like actually helping you guys and I'm not just spending like time just talking to a camera, you know. Okay, on to the next page, which is actually two pages. So this is the calendar page for February. So it just looks like this. I did multiple boxes. It actually kind of looks straight. In the video, like when you see how I made it, the black like little bars up here was actually a mess up. It was like really messed up. So I was just like, oh, forget it. And then just scribbling them all out. So I basically put down days that I have stuff. So a lot of them is soccer because I just have team snap. Now onto the video on how I did it.
Oh, okay. So this is for the calendar page. So I started off by like counting how many boxes I wanted for like each box and making it even and, you know, all that stuff. So it won't mess with my OCD. So I did that. And then I used like kind of a straight edge. I don't have a ruler, so I just kind of just went with it. Okay. So I just did that, counted all the boxes, made sure I wasn't being a dummy and, you know, going over top. Oh, look, I went over top. Okay. I wrote February in the fancy lettering that I always do. And then I started doing those little vines, but instead I did them kind of like Christmas lights. But then I put hearts around it and then started outlining everything in black. So, I really like that black pen, and it's, like, burning out. That really sucks. See, I put the days there, but it's gonna not work. But I started outlining everything in black and stuff, as you can see. And bolding, making the bold letters. Yeah. And then I erased everything. And so then I started coloring everything in pretty pinks and all my fancy nice colors. And then I started going on like Team Snap and stuff and writing down like holidays and like soccer stuff. And yeah, so I really like it. Obviously, I still have just a lot of soccer stuff, but I'm gonna sooner or later fill that with different events. But yep.
Oh, yeah. Okay, on to the next page. So we have like three more pages left. Okay, so the next page that I did was my exercise log. So it kind of looks like the calendar one. It kind of just looks like a calendar, but it's the workouts and then the times right there. And I put down like a stupid little quote right there. It says like, work hard, be healthy. These spreads are like really cute and stuff, like Valentine's Day, like related, and I really like it. On to how I did it.
Okay, so for the exercise page, I started off by writing the title and adding, shut up, Becca, oh my god. Okay, this is like really quick, but I tried to make it look like chocolates, but then I just did like a calendar way, and then I did the work hard, be healthy thing and wrote everything in black and put down the dates. I added some hearts in it, obviously, and then made the words bold. And then I erased everything, but I was just trying to make like a chocolate box, but it just didn't work out. So, I should have made like a SpongeBob page. Oh my god, I'm so doing that once I'm done with this. Okay. Yeah. But then I started like putting down like colors around the, dates. So I did like pink, lavender, purple, and red. And I think it looks cute and I gave it some color because mine were really just black and white and stuff. But then I colored in the hearts and the vines that I made. And then also the exercise log was like in pink to make it look bolder and prettier. Becca, you're so annoying. I don't even... oh my god. She's so annoying. Okay. But once I was done that, I wrote the workout and then time. And voila. So that was going to go for every single box. But I think it looks really cute. And hopefully I be healthy this month. That was bad grammar. Okay.
Okay. So the next page is going to be this. Basically, like when you're doing your journal, you want to obviously like do the multiple weeks and like make sure you repeat them. So this is like for one of the weeks. As you can see, I haven't finished the other weeks because it's literally 2 days from Friday and I didn't feel like having to do it. So. But this is like the week spreads so that every single week it would look like this. But this is for week 1 through 7 and this is for February, obviously. On to how I made it.
Okay, so for the weekly spreads, I kind of messed that up. I was writing January again. My mind, it was still January, so like I was still going through like January, but it was February. I mean, the spread. Okay, anyway, but I wrote February in black, and then I put, obviously, hearts around it, and then I wrote like the dates of the weeks, and then for the boxes, I know it looks a little messy right now, but hopefully it does get better. But I started like drawing the boxes on how I wanted, and I kind of like put them together at first so then I can get an idea. But sooner or later I uncrossed them, but I added those cute little vines, because they just look really cute. And I put a goal section because that's what I did for last, month, and it actually really helped so I can get stuff done. But once I was done with that, I obviously, I sketched everything in black. There it is. I do have a braid. Oh my god. Okay. And I started coloring some of the hearts black and then left some white. And then some of them were going to get colored in. But once I was done with that, I started, obviously you want to erase your pencil mark. So I did that. And then I wrote in the days of the week. And then also, I added the days too. But this was 1 through 7. So that's what I added. And then I colored in the hearts. What? Oh my god. Okay. And then I just made everything bold and pink. Voila.
And lastly, the last page that I have with me is the page that was also in the January spread. Is the best days of February. This is the best days of February page. It's actually really plain and simple, but I like it having plain and simple. But once that day comes, I will just put like a little Polaroid or like use my little like printer or something just to print the page out. So like the Polaroid would go right there. But this is what the page looks like. It's just plain and simple. I wanted something plain and simple. I think it looks cute. Now on to how it's made.
Okay, mistake on my part, but I totally forgot to film me painting the page, but and also writing everything down. But I cut off little pieces of paper and added February and the best day of February, little words on it, and I also just painted it all black, so it was just plain, and then just glued everything down. And this was the simplest page I had done, so yeah. But I'm sorry I didn't show you it all, but I literally just did finger painting. But yeah, and then I just let that dry overnight, and yep, that was it. That was the last page. Hopefully I will draw my SpongeBob one.
I might do another one, but
that is that. That is my journal for February.
If you guys are interested in more bullet journal videos and you guys want me to do more spreads and stuff, I will happily make them. Just don't want to make, like, I will do one, obviously, like, if you guys want me to for, like, every month, but I'm not sure if you would like to see the same pages over and over again, just being, like, the exercise and those pages. Like, I'm obviously starting, so, like, I don't have pages ideas, and slowly I'm going into it and I'm getting more ideas and stuff. I am actually really liking bullet journaling, and it's getting bulkier and stuff, so, yeah. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please give it a like and that subscribe button and comment down below, obviously, if you want me to make more of these types of videos. Okay, bye!